Hey guys, welcome back to Vss Tech. In today's video, we are going to see how the volume shadow copy service works, right? But before we know how it works, we should know what is volume shadow copy service, that is VSS, right? So a VSS is a Windows component that helps applications to have a consistent backup. It also provides a mechanism for creating consistent point-in-time copy of the data, which is known as shadow copy. And it also communicates with backup application and its components and the file system and the system hardware to provide a stable copy of your data. Let's understand the different types of shadow copies. There are two types of shadow copies, clone, full copy, and the second is copy on write, also known as CoW. Let's first understand what is clone, that is full copy. A clone is an exact full copy of the data of the source volume that is being shadow copied. These clone copies, they remain in sync with each other until you break the connection between them. And even once the connection is broken, the clone becomes independent. However, the original volume still remains intact and active. The second type of shadow copy is copy on write, CoW, also known as differential copy. In this example below, I have this Word document and I'm about to write some data on the source volume. For example, the data, let's say it's A, B, C, D, etc. And then I enable the shadow copy on this volume. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm about to overwrite the letter A with number 7. Now, when a change to the original volume occurs, but before it is written to the disk, the block that is about to be modified is written to the differential area, which preserves the data block before it is written with the change. And using the block in the differential area and the unchanged block in the original volume, a shadow copy can be logically constructed and be represented at that point of time. So, a copy and write method creates differential shadow copies instead of cloning the drive. And these shadow copies are stored in a folder named System Volume Information on the root of drive, and it has very limited permissions. Now, let's see the VSS architecture. The basic components for VSS architecture is VSS shadow copy service, the requester, the writers, the providers, okay? What happens? The requester, they request for a backups to the VSS. The VSS talks to the writers, and the writers then provide the data to the VSS, which in turns it returns back to the provider. So that's the quick workflow. In the next slide, we are going to see the function of each component in details. The first component that we will look here is requester. So basically, requester are your backup application like Windows Server Backup, Net Backup, EMC Networker, etc. They are the ones who request VSS to create shadow copies. They also communicate with the application writers to ensure they collect the correct and consistent data so that this data can be used later to restore the application in disaster-like situation. Basically, they are your backup management application that manage shadow copies creation and recovery. Now, let's discuss about writers. Yes, the writers are the application specific that stores the metadata of the data or application. They know what data of Exchange server or SQL server is important and that has to be backed up. Like this, every application has its own writers, which tells the requester what data should be backed up and also how it should be restored. Example, it provides information of the application's icons, files to include, exclude, and a strategy to restore the files. Writers also work with VSS to provide consistent shadow copies even when the application is writing data to the disk. To give you some more insight, the requester asks the VSS to give me the data. The VSS talks to the writer, gets the data that has to be backed up from an application, and then the VSS provides this data to the requester. So that data is backed up with the requester and is used when you perform a restore. Provider is the last component in VSS architecture, but the most important one. Providers are the ones who create shadow copies of the volumes, that is point-in-time copy of the source volumes. Providers respond to the signal of requester and VSS to create shadow copies. There are different types of providers depending on their functionality: hardware provider, software provider, or system software provider, that is Windows providers. The providers are critical because they talk directly to the hardware, the storage at the storage level, and with the file system in order to create the shadow copies of the data. Finally, let's see how shadow copies are created. So, you know, your requester is your backup application, right? The requester requests the VSS to gather all the writers, collect their metadata, and prepare them for shadow copies. The VSS, it then gives a green signal and says, yes, I will pass this message to the writers. The VSS then talks to the writers. It tells the writers to complete all the open transactions, to roll back transaction logs, and also to flush any cache. Once that is done, the writers are in a good state, and then they tell the VSS that our data is ready for a shadow copy creation. VSS then starts the shadow copy phase. Now, the VSS will tell the writers to freeze the application's IO writes request for 60 seconds. Meanwhile, it will freeze and flush the file system buffers to ensure file system metadata is written and in a consistent state. The writers then freeze the application's IO for exactly 60 seconds. At the same time, the VSS will tell the provider that you have just 10 seconds to prepare for the shadow copies. Once the provider creates a shadow copy of the source volume, VSS releases the writers from their temporary inactive phase and all the write queued IOs are completed. The VSS does a quick check to ensure the application IOs were paused during the shadow copy creation. After confirming the writers are in a stable state, the shadow copies are handed over to the requester by the provider to manage the backups. Okay friends, that is all for this video. I hope I was able to explain how the shadow copies are created and how the VSS works. In case if you still have any doubts, feel free to leave the comment. I'll reply back. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please hit a like and do subscribe. Cheers. Bye.